Hundreds of heart-shaped sea potatoes are washing ashore in England. The ocean is full of surprising and weird creatures, and those are just the ones we know of. It's a whole new world under the sea, and some even consider it second space. The ocean's depths may not be as vast as space, but for how close we are comparatively, we know surprisingly little. In the recent movie The Meg, a giant megalodon shark is discovered under what was thought to be the seafloor. It's actually a gas layer separating undiscovered sea creatures from the rest of the world. While that's all just part of a Hollywood movie, it wouldn't be surprising if something like that were true. In this story, we're going to see a creature that looks like it belongs in a science fiction film, yet also looks like it could belong in a romantic comedy. That might all sound very strange to you, but it will only get stranger when you see this underwater sea creature that invaded the shores of England. A mysterious creature washes ashore. Two different people found these strange creatures while walking the beaches of Penzance, Cornwall. If you're thinking that you wouldn't be too sure what to make of these creatures, neither was Rosie Hendricks. She told the BBC, "I wasn't sure what they were." She'd been walking with her family when they came across the little heart-shaped creatures. The other person who'd seen them couldn't resist making a social media post about them. A Twitter user named Tony Turner Biz had posted a picture on Twitter of the strange creatures. She tweeted, "I saw the sea potatoes this morning on Penzance Beach. Poppy thought they were worth investigating." Poppy's her dog, who was curious yet fearless to approach the little spuds. In her post, she calls them sea potatoes. This just gets weirder. What are these strange creatures? Well, these creatures seem shocking to us. If you're a marine biologist, these creatures aren't that strange at all. Oddly enough, the science community does call them sea potatoes, or sometimes they call them heart urchins for their heart-shaped bodies. Their scientific name is Echinocardium chordatum. I can see why the name sea potato stuck. Echinocardium chordatum isn't too easy on the lips. This type of urchin is found on the coast of Asian and European countries. In regards to their relation to the more common type of urchin, a professor of marine ecology at the University of Plymouth in England, Martin Attrill, had this to say. Sea urchins are cousins of the spiny and spiky ones you see on rocks and also related to starfish. They usually bury themselves in sand or mud to find food. This isn't uncommon. If these sea potatoes usually bury themselves deep in the sand, what were they doing on the coast? That's where sea potatoes are very similar to creatures like dolphins and whales. They can be subject to stranding events. Similar experiences have occurred in Long Rock Bean, according to BBC. Martin Attrill from the University of Plymouth noted that it may have been a mating event that didn't go well. The sea potatoes may have been connected to each other when the storm dragged them onto the shore. The sea potatoes look different when they're dead than they do when they're alive. Usually they have yellow-brown spines all over them, but their spines are lost when they die. That's a good thing for Tony Turner's dog, Poppy, who could have got a nose full of spines.